2500 ஆண்டுகளுக்கு முன்னால் மனித இனம் என்று வாழ்ந்தது, மனித நாகரிகம் என்று ஒன்று இருந்தது என்றால் மாவட்டத்தின் மோஸ்ட் டைனமிக் கலெக்டர் மிஸ்டர் மதுசூதன் ரெட்டி ஐஏஎஸ் அவர்களை வரவேற்பதில் மிக்க பெருமை அடைகிறோம். வைஸ் சான்சலர் ஆஃப் அழகப்பா யூனிவர்சிட்டி, ஹிஸ்டாரிக்கல் மேன் ஹூ ஹாஸ் லாட் ஆஃப் ரெபுடேஷன் இன் இஸ் அகடமிக் கேரியர். வி ஆர் வெரி ஹாப்பி டு வெல்கம் அஸ் அ கெஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஹானர் சார். வைஸ் பிரின்ஸ்பால், மெடிக்கல் சூப்பரனன், மென்ஸ் ஹாஸ்டல், லேடிஸ் ஹாஸ்டல் வார்டன், சிஆர்ஆர்ஐ குவார்ட்டர்ஸ் வைஸ் பிரசிடன்ட், ப்ரொஃபஸர்ஸ், அசோசியேட் ப்ரொஃபஸர்ஸ், அசிஸ்டன்ட் ப்ரொஃபஸர்ஸ், மேட்ரன்ஸ், ஸ்டாஃப் நர்சஸ், ஏஓஸ், அட்மினிஸ்ட்ரேட்டிவ் ஸ்டாஃப்ஸ், லேப் டெக்னீஷியன்ஸ், யங் டாக்டர்ஸ், மெடிக்கல் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ், அண்ட் லாஸ்ட் நாட் லீஸ்ட் அவர் பிளவுட் ப்ரெஸ் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ். 1-9-2015, this batch joined MBBS. It is the fourth outgoing batch of the Government Sivagangai Medical College, which started in 2012. 51 boys and 49 girls. During our MBBS days in Madurai Medical College, which started in 1954, I came to know from my teachers that only 3 times house surgeon batches were suffered previously. That is, number 1, 1962 in China war time, then 1965 and 1971 Indo-Pakistan war time. That too, male house surgeons who are giving willingness to work and help the military is taken. After that, in the history, post-independent history, we don't know what happened in First World War, Second World War. Post-independence history, the most suffered house surgeon batch is in the entire country, 2015 batch. During the completion of the last 2014 batch, we started to receive corona cases. It is from this batch, the climax, anticlimax, so many things happened, and this batch stood with all the efforts. I cannot forget the service rendered to this district by the 2015 batch of doctors. See, healthcare workers of this institution, 104 become positive. Staff nurses 41, lab technician, doctors 23, and this batch has 21 positive among themselves, and 7 of them received a remdesivir IV and 2 was treated with oxygen therapy, but none have demoralized them. எப்படி தமிழர் பரம்பரையில் அண்ணன் இறந்தா தம்பியை யுத்தத்துக்கு அனுப்புவாங்களோ, நான் கீழே போவேன் வார்டுக்கு, சார் நான் நேத்தம் பாசிட்டிவ் ஆகிட்டேன் அப்படின்னு ரெமடிசிவிர் போட்டு வென்ஃப்ளானோட ஒரு ஹவுஸ் சர்ஜன் காட்டுவான். சரி, அப்போ மேலே பாசிட்டிவ் வாலில் இவன் ஒரு ஆள் குறைன்னு நினப்பேன், ஆனால் உடனே அங்கே வந்து ஒரு ஆள் நிற்கும், சார் என் ஃப்ரெண்டு பாசிட்டிவ் ஆகிட்டான், அவனுக்கு பதிலாக நான் வந்திருக்கேன் அப்படின்னு. ஸோ தமிழ் பரம்பரையின் வீரத்தை நிரூபித்த டாக்டர்கள் இவர்கள். We lost one house surgeon in the previous batch due to corona issue. Thanks to Government of India for recognizing her services. This batch also lost the training in other branches, surgery, OG, etc., due to more postings in medicine and corona. I already told all HODs, whenever they came, you allow them, permit them, and take classes and give much exposure in surgery, OG, and other branches, which was not up to the mark because of their extra duty in the corona ward. எப்படி லடாக் பார்டரில் இருக்க நம்ம ஒரு இந்தியன் ஆர்மியோட சோல்ஜர் வந்து ஒரு லைஃப் த்ரெட்டனிங்கோடு இருக்கானோ அதே மாதிரி கவர்மெண்ட் சிவகங்கை மெடிக்கல் காலேஜ் கேம்பஸில் லாஸ்ட் 1 இயராக எல்லாத்துக்கும் வந்து ஒரு லைஃப் த்ரெட்டனிங் அப்படின்னு ஒரு 1% இருந்துக்கிட்டே தான் இருந்தது. ஐ திங்க் இட் இஸ் ஆஃப்டர் வேக்சின் இட் இஸ் கம்மிங் டவுன், பட் ஸ்டில் இட் இஸ் கோயிங் ஆன். வித் ஆல் திஸ் ஐ ப்ராமிஸ் in south tamil nadu among all medical colleges government sivagangai medical college is the best in the corona service. All aspects we proved, we stood with the people on all types of things. My dear friends, it is not over. We have to grow. How to grow? We have to become the postgraduate institution. We had 5 branches to be mostly recognized by the National Medical Commission. MS General Surgery, MD General Medicine, MD Anesthesia, MD Pediatrics and MS OG. With all this, I am confident we will get 45 postgraduates in this academic year, 21 and 22. And a National Medical Inspectors who came always as a surprise visit, have really surprised on seeing our faculty, professor, assistant professor, associate, and house surgeons approach to the patient, and they don't believe. Actually, one inspector told me, I never believe that your institution is having this short of academic standard. He actually came with the mindset that he has to help in many ways to recognize. I promise from this podium, none of the PG seats were given by sympathy. All 45 given were by the merit of the government Sivagangai Medical College. We are having academic excellence. We need infrastructure growth. Hope in the future with the dynamic collector and the government help, we will achieve the betterment of infrastructure and we will still grow. இறுதியாக அரசு சிவகங்கை மருத்துவக் கல்லூரி குடும்பத்தில் இருந்து 2015 சேர்ந்து இன்று மேலும் அடுத்த நிலைமைக்கு செல்ல தயாராக இருக்கும் எங்களுடைய குடும்பத்தின் 51 மகன்களையும் 49 மகள்களையும் அந்த இறைவன் எல்லாம் வல்ல இறைவன் அவர்களுக்கு வேண்டிய அனைத்தையும் அளித்து ஆசீர்வதிக்க வேண்டும் என்று கேட்டு வாய்ப்புக்கு நன்றி கூறி விடைபெறுகிறேன். நன்றி, வணக்கம்.
Thank you so much, sir. I invite our honorable dean sir to honor our chief guest with a memento. I invite our honorable vice principal ma'am to honor our guest of honor. Our 2015 batch, Argus Trojans, the 4th batch of Government Sivagangai Medical College, is a hard-working, dedicated, dynamic batch who shined as COVID warriors during this COVID pandemic. I request Dr. Mohammed Reynas of 2015 batch to deliver the batch report.
A very warm good afternoon to one and all. Let me begin by saying that it gives me immense pleasure and intense feel in welcoming you all to this graduation day of 2015 August Trojans Badge. First of all, I'd like to welcome our Honorable Vice Principals, Vice Principal Madam, Dean Sir, and Vice Chancellor Sir, IAS District Collector Sir, Assistant Associate Professors, HODs, and other faculties. Hence, accepting this huge privilege bestowed upon me to address the batch report of the academic year and of the academic year 2015 to 2021 of Argus Trojans Badge, I'm very privileged, and I'm going to read out the batch report of my Argus Trojans. Now, let me take you to the journey of Argus Trojans. It all started on the day of 1st September 2015, where we 100 members entered this auditorium as strangers, became friends in the dissection hall, and became blood thick in our physiology lab, and mixed with feelings while mixing chemicals in biochemistry lab. Yes, we all passed out with flying colors in first year exams, and we became Argus Trojans because we got a badge name on that day. And as a badge, we all work as one family, and we conducted our first function that was Kadir 2017 Pongal function. And from that day, it was a very good function, and we all worked together. Second, we took over the student council in 2018, and we started and conducted many inter-college functions and intra-college functions. We conducted, first of all, Tamil Mandram, that's called as Thulir 18, and it was a very grand success. And we conducted first intra-college sports fiesta, Ignitra 18. And we also conducted our very first inter-college cultural festival that is called as Mifobia 18. It was the first of the kind in GSMC because our batch was the one to conduct inter-college cultural festival in the history of GSMC. And nearly 40 colleges participated in the inter-college cultural fiesta, Mifobia 18, and 10 medical colleges and 30 non-medical colleges. And Vice Chancellor Sir, I would like to tell you that Alagappa University also took part in Mifobia 18, and they won many prizes. And Mifobia 18 was a very grand success, not only in co-curricular activities, but we also excelled in academics. My batchmates participated in many inter-college quiz competitions and have won many prizes for our colleges. And we won many inter-college quiz competitions held at different parts of Tamil Nadu. We also had many university toppers, gold medalists, and many honors from our college. And coming to sports, here in this 100, we have many Virat Kohlians, Ronaldos, and many Stephen Currys, because we also excel in sports. Let me talk about our cricket team. Our cricket team has won many championships, and one among them is, consecutive 2 years, my batchmates won inter-college sports cricket championship held at Thane Medical Colleges. A round of applause for all of you people. Second, my basketball team, volleyball team, they also participated in many colleges, and basketball has won inter-college championship held at Velamal Medical College. And talking about football, we have many Ronaldos here, but we are trying to get prizes. And my cricket team has also won, they were the runners of Stanlia 19. Here comes the end of the student period, and we were asked to enter the hospital, Government Shivagangai Medical College Hospitals, as intern doctors trainees. And my batchmates entered on 29th of March, and they took over the reins from our seniors and worked in COVID ward, and we were called as COVID CRAs. But my batchmates were up to the mark, and they worked excellently in the field of COVID, and In spite of In spite of being ill, they continuously worked. They continuously and tirelessly worked in the COVID ward, and they were looking after the people of the Shivagangai district. And I would like to tell you that my batchmates were all. Whenever we feel low while working in the COVID ward, we used to get energy from our honorable dean sir, because he was a source of energy for us. Whenever we look at him, we just get energy. I don't know why. I think he is one of the role models for all of us. I would like to tell that we are the fourth gem in the crown of GSMC, and we have always shined in that crown. And I think it was 5.5 years of journey with 2,047 days and many hours. We worked, we studied, we played, we worked. But it's very difficult to, because today is the last day of our journey and we are going to get part. But today is a memorable journey, so let us all enjoy this evening and thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Our guest of honor, Professor N. Rajendran, MA, MPhil, PhD, Vice Chancellor, Alagappa University, Karaikudi, has done his PhD in History and National Movement. He is a life member of Indian Science Congress and also a member of many academic boards. He is a member in the committee for writing History of Tamil Nadu, Tamil Nadu Development Studies for the Government of Tamil Nadu. He has authored several books and presented many papers in international and national conferences. He has published plenty of national and international journals. He was awarded the Best Book Award for his book, Sindhanai Peroli, in the year 2003. I request our guest of honor to give the convocation address.
அனைவருக்கும் இனிய மாலை வணக்கம். குட் ஈவினிங் டு எவ்ரிபடி. டிஸ்டிங்விஷ் டிஸ்ட்ரிக்ட் கலெக்டர் ஆஃப் சிவகங்கா ஸ்ரீ மதுசூதன் ரெட்டி, ரெஸ்பெக்டட் டீன் டாக்டர் ஏ ரத்னவேல், தி வைஸ் பிரின்சிபல் டாக்டர் என் ஷர்மிளா திலகவதி, the teaching faculty, the administrative staff, distinguished guests, the press and media, parents and dear graduates, good evening to all of you. At the outset, I thank the dean for having invited me to deliver the graduation day address of this esteemed medical college. This is the second time I am entering the portals of this great institution. The Government Medical College and hospitals have all along been the providers of much needed health services to the economically weaker sections of our country. But unfortunately, their contribution remains mostly out of limelight. The Government Medical College and hospital established at Sivaganga in 2012 is doing great service to the marginalized people of this region. Equipped with all modern sophisticated instruments, advanced operation theater facility, emergency, 24-hour casualty, intensive care unit, neonatal intensive care unit, pediatric intensive care unit, 108 ambulance facility, the 1,300 bedded hospital, and well-equipped medical personnel, it caters to the emergency needs of thousands and thousands of people of this Sivaganga district. Besides, the college hospital has yoga and neurotherapy unit. Certainly, young friends, you must feel proud to be the alumni of this college. Graduation is one of the most important milestones in the course of your academic career. Graduation is not the end of a tough journey, but it is the beginning of a beautiful one with promises for a bright future. Dear graduates, your parents, by their sacrifices, have enabled you to become graduates. They gave everything to you to make you a graduate. And hence it is an apt time to show your gratitude to them. You must reciprocate their unconditional love for you through your services to them. I hope all of them are watching this graduation ceremony. It is being webcast, I believe. Because due to COVID situation, they are not allowed to be here in this very hall. You have to be grateful to your teachers, who are your second parents. The place accorded to Guru in Indian culture is unparalleled. Even great emperors bowed their heads before their gurus. Those who respect their teachers alone prosper in their life. The life of Aristotle, Alexander the Great, Swami Vivekananda, Dr. Ambedkar, and Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam will proclaim the reality of this dictum. Kabir Das once said, "If God and my teacher appear in person, I will first bow my head to my teacher, because it is he who showed me God." On this great occasion, you must salute your professors who have imparted the necessary skills and knowledge in this profession. At the time of independence, the country had 330 crore population. Famine and starvation epidemics and of communicable diseases took massive toll of human life. Infant and maternal death rates were among the highest in the world, and life expectancy was just above 33 years. There were about 50,000 medical graduates and 25,000 nurses belonging to modern system of medicine to provide health care to the population in this country. Soon after independence, the country embarked on a massive expansion of medical and paraprofessional training to meet the needs of the proposed expansion in healthcare system. There is a paradigm shift in the world today that we live. The paradigm shift is we have moved from literary society to knowledge society. In these days of knowledge explosion and research, the graduates have to concentrate on updating their knowledge by reading current research journals and attending important seminars and conferences. Otherwise, they will become outmoded without knowing the latest developments in the field. This is very essential for medical fraternity too. We all have heard old saying, "Health is wealth," which is a great American philosopher, Ralph Waldo Emerson, said, as the first wealth is health. Health and hygiene are essential aspects of a good life. That is because one cannot enjoy a wholesome life without good health. Health means the state of being mentally, physically, and emotionally well. On the other hand, hygiene refers to cleanliness and is an important element of health. A good life leads to good health. It is essential to be healthy and hygienic to build your body's immune system. Practicing good hygiene helps in preventing the spread of diseases and illness. It is beyond any shadow of doubt that health and hygiene go hand in hand. Hippocrates and Imhotep are some of the most ancient doctors in the world who contributed a lot towards mankind. In India, the history of medicine goes way back to the times of Sushruta and Charaka, who were the first surgeons in the world who lived in the Gupta era. All these men belong to different era and background. However, their dedication and passion for saving lives and mending them are what makes them stand together. They represent the community known as the doctors. Health is a nation-building strategy. The students and scholars who will be receiving degrees, awards, and prizes today are India's investment capital for building a better future. You are the elite with the talent, skills, and knowledge needed to spearhead improvements in India's health system. You are the torchbearer of this system. We are at a crucial stage amidst the COVID-19 pandemic, which has been well elaborated by your dean, the sacrifices made by the doctors here, interns here. While we celebrate this momentous occasion, the graduation day, let us all salute the frontline health workers, the doctors, nurses, technicians, transporters, emergency medical technologists, and everyone who supported the patient care during this pandemic, risking their own health and life. Our government has launched the world's largest health scheme called Ayushman Bharat, which comprises creation of 1,50,000 health and wellness centers by upgrading the sub-health centers and rural and urban primary health centers, and Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, under which around 10.74 crore poor and vulnerable families have been identified as per socio-economic caste census, and they are entitled for a health cover of rupees 5 lakhs per family per year for secondary and tertiary care hospitalization. The diagnosis of the root cause of a disease has been well said by the great Tamil poet Thiruvalluvar in Thirukkural as follows: Noi Nadi, Noi Mudal Nadi, Adu Tanikkum Vai Nadi, Vai Pachayal. Consider the disease and its root and the means of curing it, and then set about the cure with every precaution. The future of health care is shaping up in front of our own eyes with advances in digital healthcare technologies such as artificial intelligence, virtual reality, augmented reality. We have to familiarize with the latest developments in order to be able to control technology and not the other way around. The future of healthcare lies in working hand in hand with technology, and healthcare workers have to emerge emerging healthcare and technologies in order to stay relevant in the coming years. I learned patients who receive care in research active hospitals have better health outcomes. This is due to the research active hospital being able to offer wider treatment options and more opportunities to be included in clinical trials. Research active institutions have an ethos of advancing learning, and so benefits the patients. Patients taking part in clinical trials tend to have increased time with clinical team members. Therefore, problems are likely to be identified sooner. Taking part in research can help patients gain a better understanding of their condition and management. In this context, we in Arayappa University, we have biotechnology, biomedical science, microbiology departments with sophisticated instruments to carry out modern research in medical field. We believe that roots of good teaching are indeed nourished in the soil of research. On this occasion, I call upon the medical fraternity to collaborate with each other for mutual benefit and for the health care of our country. The Tamil Nadu model of public health is renowned for its success in providing quality health services at an affordable cost, especially to the rural poor. Tamil Nadu is the only state with a distinctive public health care in the district level, and also the first state to enact Public Health Act in 1939. Tamil Nadu has gained significant ground in the various aspects of health in the last few decades, largely because of the significant reforms in its health sector, which dates back to 1980s. We saw the rigorous expansion of rural health infrastructure in the state, besides deployment of thousands of multi-purpose health workers as village health nurses in rural areas. Dear graduates, you must all have dreams in your life, as Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam beckons us. First, conceive an idea which is really your dream. Believe in it and go for it. You will definitely realize your dreams. If you can conceive the dream in your mind, plant in your heart and water it daily, then it will grow and become a reality. One has to translate plans into practices. Aim high. If you have less aim, it's a crime, said Benjamin May. If you have a lofty aim, you can work on it and achieve it. My dear graduates, you might face setbacks at times, but that should not upset you, as neither success nor failure is permanent. Obstacles and difficulties are part of our journey to success. Believe that perseverance, hard work, and unshakable determination shall always triumph. Never give up hope. The life of Stephen William Hawking, the celebrated modern-day physicist, who was afflicted with a rare disease called motor neuron disease, confined to a wheelchair till he was 76 years old. He was a theoretical physicist, cosmologist, and author, and director of research at the Center for Theoretical Cosmology at the University of Cambridge at the time of his death at the age of 76. I am confident that you are being sent into the wide world by this institution with the objective you are bound to win, for you are adequately equipped with the spirit supplied by this great institution in Sivaganga Medical Hospital and College. May your life be bright one. Accept my congratulations and march towards the land of bright future. Wish you good luck. Thank you.
Thank you for your thought-provoking speech, sir. Our honorable chief guest, Mr. Madhusudan Reddy, IAS, has formerly worked as sub-collector at Perambalur and Dindigul districts. He has also worked as deputy commissioner of health in Greater Chennai Corporation. He had a very large role in controlling COVID-19 in 2020 at Chennai, and his work was well appreciated by the Union Health Ministry. He is such a dynamic, hardworking person, and sir, we are very gifted to have you in this wonderful occasion. I request our honorable chief guest to address the gathering.
Good evening, everyone. A respected Vice Chancellor of the Alagappa University, Dean of the Government Sivagangai Medical College, the Vice Principal, Professors, Associate Professors, Assistant Professors, and other non-teaching staff of the Medical College, and the heroes and the heroines of today's, you know, convocation or the graduation day, this passing out students of the 2015 batch of Government Medical College at Sivagangai, and press and media, good evening to everyone once again. I take this as an honor to be in front of you on this day, which is so valuable for 100 students in their career. It's a landmark event for any student or for anybody to get, go out with flying colors from our first graduation, be it any kind of a graduation. And that too, you are graduating from a very, very noble profession. You have large responsibility bestowed on your shoulders. Whatever you have did or you have done so far in life will be very minuscule when compared to the journey you are marching on. The journey which welcomes you is, you know, coming in a very, very challenging times and tough times for the medical fraternity and the public health of this world, not the country alone. This is a once in a century phenomenon when we observe the history of the public health. So you might be all aware that one or the other communicable disease keeps on coming into the humanity one way or the other in some part of the country, and because of the more mobility induced in this century compared to the previous communicable diseases, this has much more wider ramifications on our lives, on our economy, on our livelihoods, and so much, unprecedented things. Even for example, somebody who would have been loving so much of movies, or who would have been going to the religious places or going to the school, we could have never imagined that, you know, for 1 year the educational institutions will be shut, or the religious places will be shut, or any other things will be shut, and except the hospitals in this country. And there is no institution which was allowed to function except the healthcare institution across the globe for the past 1 year. In many occasions, in many restricted areas, doctors and the healthcare professionals were the lonely professionals who were, allowed to function, because their services were absolutely necessary to save the humanity at this hour of very, very, tough situation. It is not only tough, it is very, very strange. It's a new kind of a disease, though COVID was known, but not this strain of COVID. So people were very new on how to deal with it, or, how to get trained. If you, recollect the journey back to the February 2020, we got all the learnings or all the inputs given to the doctors or paramedical staff, or whoever is involved in the COVID management, only through the virtual learning. How to, starting from basics like, how to wear a PPE suit, or, how to take a swab. From such basics, the education or the learning was imported. The skills were imported online, and the doctors and the paramedics were allowed to, work. It is rather, they came forward to work when everybody is taking rest, and when everybody was allowed to stay home, not to step out. So imagine the bravery and the gravity of these great hearts and souls who have come forward despite losing their colleagues' lives. It is not that, it is like entering into a very, very unknown area of work. Though you might be doing surgeries, if it is known disease, we all know how to handle it. Your professors are there to teach you, or somebody is there to guide you, because there is a precedent, there is a procedure, there is well-written document on how to do it, so we will read and do it. But when the society itself is scared, or when they are afraid to, see, I have seen instances where the family has abandoned the dead bodies, telling that, no, we don't mind if you cremate. We are not willing to come to the crematorium. So you do the crematorium, means cremation. See, in our country, we never lose, or we never, forget to attend the last rituals. That is our culture. But if such a situation is there, where the closest family members, are not coming forward for the fear of infection, that may be their lack of understanding or lack of clarity about the disease. But whatever it is, I just want to, remind you of the context in which, all of you have worked through. So why I am telling a large introduction on COVID is, it is not that the healthcare or all of you are worried only about COVID. It is because you are in this particular year of very, very tumultuous period in your house surgeonship. You have spent entire year in handling the COVID. That's where makes your batch very, very special, and a very, very courageous batch. So my wholehearted appreciations to all of you. See, there is always a choice for you. You can run away from the medical college and again do your house surgeoncy. But you have, all of you have chosen to work, as the dean said, to work here and contribute to this district and to the medical profession. I should congratulate all of you on this great day in your lives. In fact, it is a great day in my life too, for coming to this place. For the only reason I came is that I should not miss this batch of students who have really risked their lives in protecting the people of this district, or for that matter neighboring district, who come here for the accessing the medical care. Having said so, The world is wide open for you. It is not, the days are gone where the doctors are sitting and attending to the patients physically. Now the great technological solutions have come. Please embrace the technology. You multiply your efforts or your way of treating. You should treat or you should try to treat as many number of people or as many types of people with the great use of the technology. To the remotest part of the people also, we can provide through the digital solutions. You would have seen the greatest, that is another advantage for your batch. You would have seen the greatest use of technology in the medical field. In this time of COVID, without the presence of a doctor, we have gone and through online, you have counseled the patients, you have attended to the COVID people or to their families counseling, or even the radiologists have completely read and then given their prescriptions over the emails, etc. So this technological embracement really gives you an edge over the previous generations, because you are just born before the millennial age. So you all have the potential to embrace the technology, and please be embracing all the time to the new endeavors. This 1 year would have given you the much more courage to face anything in life. I am sure you will never bow before any disease in your life. To be afraid that, I cannot treat this patient. It is very highly infectious. On this ground, you will never be worried till, our lives are there on this earth. This much confidence I fully have on all the passing out graduates of this great medical college. Being the fourth batch of this medical college, I should tell you that you have left a great legacy in the history of this college. It is not only for you, you have been the great role models for your juniors. If tomorrow, if someone asks a question also, your dean will be so proud to tell that the batch of 2015 have served the whole of this district or the student, these patients who have come here without even asking an excuse. So you should be like them. So you will be an example in this college history to be cited as the great role models as a batch. See, it is possible to get one role model. It is not easy to become the role model of the entire batch. So usually we will hear that, okay, in that batch, that doctor used to be there, or that boy used to be there, that girl used to be there, who is very, very helpful and friendly to everybody. Now you have earned the recognition that all of you are such nice, good doctors who have come forward willingly to treat and do the things. So please embrace the technology and please be proud of what you are and what you will be in future. That alone makes us take forward in life. Please be confident. And now the healthcare is evolving into very, very multidisciplinary function. It was not the olden days where we do MBBS and N. Now, with everywhere, Tamil Nadu being one of the most developed states in the country, we have advanced facilities even in the smallest town of the state. So having being so many facilities, you will be facing a lot of challenges to strive and be excel in your career and settle down as one of the greatest doctors of this nation or maybe in the world also. So I wish you all the best. We would like to see you somewhere in other positions, maybe down the line after 5-6 years, as very, very greatly achieved men and women of this country. I wish you all the best and great success in future ahead. Thank you for the opportunity.
Thank you so much, sir, for your valuable words. I invite Dr. Srivatsan and Dr. Poovili Parashakti to present the graduation pledge. I request everyone to rise up from their seats and also from their hands for the pledge.
Vishal in thought.
All may repeat.
Vishal in thought.
Word and deed.
Be ever honest.
In the discharge of our duties.
And uphold the dignity.
And integrity of our profession. And the honor.
And the name of our university.
And our alma mater.
We swear to serve the sick and ailing patients under our care and all those who need our services to the best of our ability without any consideration of caste, creed or status.
All may be seated. It's time to honor the university toppers and the gold medalist.
I request our chief guest and guest of honor to adorn the medal and give the certificate for the 2015 batch students.
The university toppers and gold medalists. First year, anatomy, Divya, university topper and gold medalist. She holds both university topper and gold medalist in the Department of Anatomy.
Students can remove their mask when they are getting the award. Divya, university topper, gold medalist in anatomy. Anjana B. Nair, university topper in physiology. Divya, university topper and gold medalist in anatomy. Next, physiology, Anjana B. Noye. Anjana. For the Department of Biochemistry, university topper, Anjana. The biochemistry, Anjana, university topper. The second year department, pharmacology, Anjana. University topper in the Department of Pathology, Divya. University topper in the department that is microbiology, Indra. Microbiology, Indra. Forensic medicine, Parkavi. University topper in forensic medicine, Parkavi. Ophthalmology, Arya. For ENT, Anjana. Social and preventive medicine, Pirai Sudan. Social and preventive medicine, Pirai Sudan. The general medicine, Prashant. He holds the university topper and also gold medalist in the medicine. Prashant, university topper in medicine. Prashant, gold medalist in medicine. Prashant, gold medalist in medicine. General surgery, Pirai Sudan holds the university topper. Pirai Sudan for surgery. OG Prashant, university topper. OG Prashant, university topper. Pediatrics, university topper, Sharmila Kamali. Pediatrics, university topper, Sharmila Kamali. Pediatrics gold medal, Rupen Chakravarti. Pediatrics university topper, Sharmila Kamali, and the gold medalist, Rupen Chakravarti.
Dr. Keshavaraj, Graduates, first Dr. Keshavaraj. Dr. Shiva Prakash. Dr. Ahmed Sirajuddin. Dr. Ajit Kumar. Dr. Akalya. Dr. Aragamai. Dr. Amala. Dr. Anbaragan. Dr. Angu Meenachi. Dr. T.K. Anjana. Dr. Anjana B. Nair. Dr. Arun. Dr. Arya. Dr. Dr. Bharati. Dr. Bharat. Dr. Bhavani. Dr. Deeksha Dwivedi. Dr. Deepak Kumar. Dr. Dharani. Dr. Dharmaraj. Dr. Divya. Dr. Ganga Devi. Dr. Gayatri Appar. Dr. Gilton. Dr. Gautam. Dr. Gunaram. Dr. Dr. Ilavarasi. Dr. Indra. Dr. Juliet Arogya Mary.
Dr. Kannappan. Dr. Kannappan. Dr. Kapil Ganesh. Dr. K.V. Karthik. Dr. G. Karthika. Dr. M. Karthikeyan. Dr. Kavinesh. Dr. G. Kirtana. Dr. P. Kirtana. Dr. Kausalya. Dr. S. Dr. G. Manikandan. Dr. Mari Raj. Dr. Pavitra.
Dr. Pragalya.
Shanmugam.
Thank you.
Dr. Srinidhi.
சார் அண்ட் விபி மேம் ரொம்ப எக்ஸைட்டடாக இருந்தாங்க. அவங்க தான் ஃபங்க்ஷன் நாளை ரிகர்சல்லாம் பார்த்தோம். தேங்க்யூ சார், தேங்க்யூ மேம். அண்ட் சுந்தரம் சார் ஃபார் கைடிங் அஸ் த்ரூ திஸ் இயர். இந்த ஆசையாக மிஸ் ஃபுல்லாக பார்த்துக்கிட்டாரு, எல்லாமே கைட் பண்ணார். அண்ட் ஆல் அவர் அசிஸ்டன்ட் ப்ரொஃபஸர்ஸ் அண்ட் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் ஃபார் மேக்கிங் சீம் அண்ட் அ கிரேட் சக்ஸஸ். தேங்க்யூ, தேங்க்யூ.
Thank you.
Dr. Shiva Prakash for basketball and volleyball. Dr. Suresh Kumar for volleyball.
For volleyball.
Thank you. all, I'd like to thank our God Almighty for making us this function a grand success. He has showered his blessings on us and made this function a successful one. I'd like to thank our Dean Sir, a big, great thanks to Dean Sir, right from the day he accepted for this graduation ceremony. Each and every step, Sir was with us, and he planned all the minute details of this functions. So this function has gone down in a very smooth manner. The secret behind this is the best planning of our Dean Sir. He's a role model for each and everyone at this college. A big thank you, sir. I would like to thank our guest of honor, Vice Chancellor of Alagappa University, Professor Dr. Rajendran Sir. When we extend our invitation, sir immediately accepted our invitation without any hesitations. In spite of this COVID situation, sir didn't hesitate at all. A big thank you, sir, for accepting and coming here for the second time. I would like to thank our district collector, Dr. Madhusudana Reddy, sir. Sir was very busy in the elections, but in spite of that, he too accepted and he has come. Whenever we call in our college for any function, sir is ready to accept our invitation. A big thank you, sir. I would like to thank all our faculties, professors, associate professors, HODs, office staff, everyone who have come to this function to grace the occasion. I thank our office team who has been who has been organizing and the stage events. A big thank you to all. I thank our matron, junior students who have made this function a success by helping us in all the events. Thanks to RMO Madam, ARMOs who are behind the organizing team. I thank our press people who have come here for the coverage of this event. A big thanks to the parents who have come here. Without the parents, you have not become a graduate here. A big thanks to all the parents who have supported you to come undergo this course. Thank you all. And I thank our Crystal workers who have made the maintenance work and cleanliness in the campus. A big thank you to all, and I wish all the best to all the graduates who have come here and have a bright and a successful future. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now let's all raise up for the national anthem.
Janaganamana Adhinayaka Jayahe Bharata Bhagya Vidhata Punjab Sindh Gujarat Maratha Dravida Utkala Vanga Vindhya Himachala Yamuna Ganga Uchchala Jaladhi Taranga तव शुभ नामे जागे तव शुभ आशीष मांगे गाहे तव जय गाथा जन गण मंगल दायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे
ऑल बैच मेंबर्स ऑफ 2K15 आर रिक्वेस्टेड टू स्टेप ऑन द स्टेज फॉर ग्रुप फोटो
என்ன உண்மையிலேயே ஆர்மி தான்டா கிரேட்டு இன்னும் 11 மாசம் எங்கேயோ பணி இல்லையோ பழைய என்ன உண்மையிலேயே ஆர்மி தான்டா கிரேட்டு
இங்கு உறவுகள் பிரிவுகள் வருதே சில அழகிய வரிகளும் தருதே போகின்றோம் தூரம் தூரம் செல்லும் உணர்வுகள் ஓய்வரே நெஞ்சில் நடந்து போகும் காதல் தென்றல் கூட கடந்து போகும் இப்பயணத்தில் உன் நினைவுகள் நெஞ்சடைக்குமே காடு மலை செல்ல துவங்கும் போது நெஞ்சில் சொந்தங்களின் நினைவு போது கை குழந்தையை அடைக்கவே நீ துடிக்குமே
Beloved seniors, please arrange yourselves in such a way that all the faces are visible in the photo. The one standing at the back, it seems that their face is not visible. Please arrange yourselves, my beloved seniors. The people in the front row are requested to sit down so that the other's face will be visible. Please spread yourselves in the stage. Please cooperate.
அன்பன் நன்றி உங்களுக்கு
தேடி வந்த சாமிதாரி தோஸ்து
மஜாபா இதா
சிறிருக்கு வேற என்ன வேணும் உல்லாசமா இருக்கும் என்ன வேணும் நடக்கட்டும் சந்தோஷமா இருக்கும் வேணும் உல்லாசமா இருப்பேன்
ஏதோ பஞ்சா போட்டுடுவோம்ப்ளா
லந்தா
அந்த நாலு பேரை
சம்பந்தம்
Thank you.
patita. A ver, los pibes si me ayudan con esto. ¿Qué dice? La Marta. Se mueve para, 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 se mueve para. Esta es la Marta más loca que hay. ¡Hueva!
¡No para!
ఇది నాకు తట్టలేదు గానీ అన్న ఈ లోపలేది బబ్లుగమ్ము అంత కొన్నదంటే పోదు నమ్ము మూడు నుంచి ఎంతన్న మాట గానీ మళ్ళీ ఎంతన్నానేమో ఇది చెప్పకుండా చెప్పు నమ్ము